Welcome to the second episode in my brand new Build Showcase series. So in the last episode, we showcased an amazing beach slash summer house. And in today's episode, we're using stained clay as the main building block once again to make something completely different. So we can get to 5 likes in today's video, that would be insane. And yeah guys, without further ado, let's get today's episode started. Okay, and welcome back to the mainland. So as you can see, like I said in that intro there, in the last episode, we showcased a beach slash summer house using stained clay as the main block, and honestly I think it turned out really well. But in today's build, I did the same thing once again, but instead of using light blue hardened clay, I use red hardened clay. And what I used it for is a nice horse stable. So as you can see, we used a lot of oak wood and red stained clay to really form the build, and I think it looks really cool, and I think it came out really good with then lots of hay bales in the backyard that I'll be showing you in just 1 second. And yeah guys, I honestly think that we were able to incorporate so many layers of that design to get this look of a real horse stable. So yeah, let's get this showcase underway. So we're gonna be starting out in the front. As you can see, we used the oak wood logs as kind of as a pop color, because if we just had a massive box of red stained clay, it would look kind of ugly. So as you can see, we used the oak wood logs to break up the red stained clay, as you can see in this border here, and we used it on the edges, and I think it just creates a good outline. And then we used the oak wood stairs and half slabs for the roof. Now I think it really creates just a nice old-fashioned feel, since that these are kind of, except from the red, these were the main colors that people used not that long ago. We really did use the fences as the windows, because you don't really see glass in horse stables, you see kind of fence-like windows, and we did that all the way around the horse stable. Now something that I'm pretty proud of, we actually have a redstone door. So as you can see, if I go out of F1 mode here, if it's nighttime and we don't want creepers coming in and exploding our horses, we can just close the vents, and then if we want to get in, we open these two levers here, and then we can get inside. But like I said, I'll be showing that off in 1 second. We also used fences as kind of a little detail, really wasn't anything that special. We used hay bales to really break up all the red, since it was kind of getting a little bit like, oh wow, red, red, red. It was too much red. So we used, you know, the hay bales, which does have red in it, but that incorporates another color. It incorporates a little bit of yellow, a little bit of green. I honestly think so look really good. And then we added even more color by adding in a darker green and a darker brown for the backyard, which I will be showing off in 1 second. So let's go inside the build. So as you can see, when we go in here, you know, no horse stable has grass inside, so we use the coarse dirt and pod soil to really make a unique floor design. And this will stay dirt forever, since coarse dirt does not turn into grass. Now, as we can see, we have the horses in each and every stable. And then we even added some detail into the roof. As you can see, if I break one block of the stair here, that's the roof. Now what we did is we used these oak wood stairs backwards to give it, like, so it's like the roof has like a little roof, and we used the slabs just to do a nice border to kind of give it kind of like a pyramid effect kind of, and I think it looks really darn cool, really cool. I'm super proud of this build, as you can probably see. And as you can see, we have these nice little stables using oak wood logs and fences. And yeah, we have all the nice horses having their nice little pen. And if you guys want to, you can even get some hay bales. So we just go to hay bales, we just type in hay, and then if you want to make it so you have food. But honestly, these pens are kind of small, so if you want to, you can even place some there, but that's fine. But yeah, so now for the main part of the build, the outside. So as you can see, we have the same floor again with the coarse dirt in the pod soil. We have hay bales, and basically what you could do is you could take your horse out here, you can go on the nice course jumping around. If your horse gets tired, you can come to this little rest stop here, which we really incorporated some detail into the roof using corner stairs to kind of give it this nice border. It can take some drink from the cauldron and some more hay bales to eat. There's some good high jumps here, and then it can go back in there when it is tired. So what are the main detail elements that we are trying to show off in this build? You know, just adding more and more layers. If you have blank walls, try to either add bushes, try to do a little bit of landscaping, and that really adds some more detail. And it really just doesn't make it look like, you know, just all the same color walls. And also, when you have a theme, use blocks that goes along with that theme. As you can see, we could have just used glass panes as the windows, but we use fences since it kind of goes along with the theme just a little bit better. So let's take one more look at this build. And there we go, guys. As you can see, we're on the same angle as we did in this first episode of the series. So, yeah, as you can see, it is a very simple building. And I strongly recommend all these buildings for people that are just getting into building and really want to start incorporating detail and theme into their build. So thank you guys so much for watching this video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please leave a like and subscribe down below. As always, my website is going to be in the description below. Go take a look, see what you see. And if you have any suggestions for my website, please leave in the comments. Also, if you want to leave any notes to me, you can leave it in Squid's mailbox, which is also on that website. And yeah, guys, if you guys have any ideas for this series and want me to showcase something, want me to build this build in Buildcraft, please say so in the comment section below. I want to see a lot of comments today. But yeah, guys, until next time, we'll see you later. Goodbye. Bye.